with a talk of a Scott Disick and Sofia Richie engagement amping up, it had us stop to think about something. What if Momma Kris is right and Kourtney Kardashian is going to regret letting Scott go one day?
And she's gonna be the one deciding way too late that she is in love with Scott and wants to spend the rest of her life with Scott.
A source has revealed that Kourtney is on the fence when it comes to Scott marrying anyone. Therefore, we thought this would be a good time to discuss all the reasons why Kourtney and Scott are meant to be. The hopeless romantic in me is about to jump out, and trust me, you don't wanna miss it. How's it going, guys? I'm Madison Hill. If you ship Scott Disick and Kourtney Kardashian at all, then you are going to live for this. But before we start our walk down memory lane, do me a favor and please click that subscribe button and the bell for notifications. That way you're always the first one to the tee. As you all know, Kourtney Kardashian and Scott Disick dated for 9 long years from 2006 to 2015. They share 3 children together, and I think it's safe to say that Scott has definitely solidified his position as part of the Kardashian clan. Now, of course, there's no denying that during those 9 years, the two didn't go through some major struggles. From cheating allegations to Scott's wild partying, he definitely put Kourtney through the ringer, which is of course why the two ultimately decided to split and go their separate ways. Kourtney has dated a few younger men, but her longest relationship was with Yunus Benjema, while Scott, on the other hand, has pretty much stuck to one woman for the most of his post-Kourtney life, and that is Sofia Richie. Scott and Sofia have been dating for a little more than 2 years, and as of recently, the two have started to seriously consider taking things to the next level. A source shared to Us Magazine that these two are, quote, having serious conversations about getting engaged because they truly feel like they are each other's life partners. While that's a sweet sentiment, we've also heard, thanks to a source speaking to Radar Online, that Sofia is truly the one pushing for this. She reportedly wants Scott to do something to prove that he's in it for the long haul, whether that's a ring or a baby. As I mentioned, being that Scott already has 3 children with Kourtney, it's logical that a ring would be him and Sofia's next step. And we heard this is something Kourtney originally was on board with. However, clearly now that things have started to become more real, and even Momma Kris has shared her concerns with Kourtney one day living with regret, she's had a slight change of heart. In a recent report from Life and Style magazine, a source revealed that Kourtney is, quote, on the fence about Scott getting married. And honestly, it doesn't have much to do with Sofia. She apparently likes Sofia. It's just hard for her to imagine Scott marrying anyone due to their long history. And as much as I tried to deny it, I agree with Kourtney here. I think despite her and Scott having some very bad moments in their past, they also have a lot of good. Not to mention, they are family at the end of the day. On top of that, Sofia's family also has some concerns about her and Scott taking that next step. In a recent report from OK Magazine, a source revealed that Sofia's family is concerned with how little time she makes for her siblings and parents these days. The insider shared, quote, Sofia has always been easily influenced and Scott's done a real number on her. Apparently, Sofia, quote, talks like a robot who's been programmed to follow his every command. Therefore, the source says when someone from her family calls her out, it really upsets Sofia. The source ended the insider info saying, quote, her family is so grossed out at how she's living her life, they hope she snaps out of it soon. Therefore, with Kourtney starting to feel some regret and Sofia's family not being on board, I think this brings us to the walk I keep talking about. Tap into your hopeless romantic and let's dive into the reasons as to why these two belong together despite their troubled past. Number 1, Momma Kris, the Kardashian matriarch, think so. In another recent report from Life and Style magazine, a source close to the momager revealed that she has not given up on the belief that Kourtney and Scott will end up together. The source went on to say, quote, Kris has been very vocal about it, but still holds out hope that Scott might come to his sense and marry her daughter. And if that's not enough to convince you Momma Kris believes these two are meant to be, then wait until you hear this. The insider went on to say, quote, in fact, Kris still has notes from various weddings she was planning for them. She refuses to throw them away. So yeah, if Momma Kris is still holding on to wedding plans that she already has for Kourtney and Scott, that to me is a major sign that Kourtney and Scott's future isn't doomed just yet.
So you're telling me there's a chance?
Yes, I most definitely am. And another reason is that Momma Kris isn't the only one who's still holding out hope that Kourtney and Scott will end up together. Khloé is also one of their biggest cheerleaders. Let's take a moment to reminisce on when Kylie celebrated her 21st birthday and Scott attended the celebration while Sofia Richie's invite got lost in the mail. Keep in mind, this was before everyone was cool with each other like they supposedly are now. Anyway, Khloé had the internet and us here at Hollyscoop shook when she posted this Snapchat of Kourtney and Scott sitting next to one another with the caption, "A girl can dream." Obviously, after this post, there were reports that Sofia wasn't totally comfortable with that situation, which I don't think anyone can blame her for. I'm just saying, I think it's clear that if Kourtney and Scott announced a reconciliation tomorrow, the family would be on board.
I support you.
Let's move on to yet another reason these two are meant to be, the fact an emotional healer in Bali said so. During a recent episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Kourtney revealed that during her session with an emotional healer, they revealed that her and Scott are soulmates.
Scott came in and the guy was basically saying that in a past life that we were together and that we're soulmates.
At that point, Kourtney says her and Scott had to decide whether or not they wanted to be together. We know in the episode they decide to just stay co-parents. However, there's always time for more. Okay, moving on to our next reason why Kourtney and Scott are meant to be, the fact that Scott has admitted before that he wants more children with Kourtney.
Oh my God. Scott wants to have another baby?
Yeah.
With who?
With Kourtney.
Back in September, Kim admitted to known Car Jenner pal Larsa Pippen that Scott revealed he wanted another baby with Kourtney. Not, you know, his current girlfriend at the time, and now Sofia Richie.
I think he just wants one more.
Well, she definitely wants more kids.
And she wants one more.
If they both want to have more kids, like, why not have them together?
As I mentioned before, when this was filmed, Scott was obviously with Sofia, and Kourtney was actually with Eunice Benjma. Therefore, Kim suggested that they stay faithful to their partners and just conceive another child through IVF.
That seems like a reasonable request.
However, putting myself in Sofia and Eunice's shoes, I don't think I'd be too keen on the fact that my significant other was revisiting having kids with their ex. Yes, of course, they have children together currently and co-parent, but still, that's just a tad uncomfortable. Therefore, I think if Scott and Kourtney still have any part of them that wants more children with the other, that tells me that all of the feelings they have for one another are not dead, AKA, this proves they're still meant to be. Another clip that will give you all the Kourtney and Scott feels took place during the Keeping Up with the Kardashians 10-year anniversary special. This is one of the first times the co-parents discussed their final breakups on camera. And even here, you can sense the two still have chemistry. It didn't help that Scott also admitted he still tries to hook up with Kourtney consistently.
Yeah, I try to f*** her like once a week.
After that moment, Kourtney was asked if things are really over, and honestly, she couldn't even get the words out, which is why Kim took over and said what she was thinking. And let me warn you, it wasn't that things are really over.
I feel like she has to say the door's closed, just like to make the point.
Because of the debauchery that's going on.
Can we just let her talk?
Kourtney goes on to admit that a lot had happened in their relationship that had gotten them to the closed door state, but even Scott goes on to say, it's not totally over.
But it's been about Oprah.
Granted, this was pre-Sofia, but I'm just saying, I feel like the sparks are still there even though Kourtney was trying to deny it, similar to what I sense is happening now. All right, our next moment that proves Kourtney and Scott are most likely meant to be is the fact they both get very irritated at the thought of the other being with someone else. Example one, when Scott found out that Eunice Benjma and Kourtney were official. In January of last year on Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Kourtney confides in Khloé that Scott called her at 2 a.m. asking what they were each doing with their dating lives.
And he was just like ranting, like, what are we doing in life? What are you doing? What am I doing?
Although this doesn't quite sound like the perfect time to let your boyfriend of 9 years know you're officially with someone else, Kourtney did at the end of the conversation, and Scott was not pleased.
He was like, he's your boyfriend? And then
that was a trigger, of course.
And then he hung up the phone.
As I mentioned, the jealousy is not one-sided. Let's not forget how Kourtney reacted when Scott brought the kids around Sofia for the first time. While I understand she's concerned for her kids, I think that also stemmed from some resentment that Scott's relationship worked, and as we all know, hers didn't.
It's called giving someone a heads up and having a respectful conversation, giving someone the respect.
I'm just saying, I feel like for them both to have such strong reaction to the other seeing someone else, there has to still be something there. But hey, that is strictly my own opinion. And like I said at the beginning of this, I'm a hopeless romantic. Therefore, while I know Scott has put Kourtney through a lot, I can't help but look back on some of these times and think there's a lot of history and a lot of signs pointing to the fact that these two are meant to be.
It's meant to be.
And if those clips aren't enough, just look at these Instagrams of them together as a family. You can't deny both of them look pretty happy. However, now that we're nearing the end of our walk down memory lane, it's important to snap back to reality and remember. Scott is reportedly happy with Sofia, while Kourtney as well, ready to be in love again, but still hasn't quite found it. Girl, welcome to the club. I guess you never know, she could take her own walk down memory lane and come to the conclusion that she's no longer on the fence and ready to let Scott go, or realize all of these things prove they're meant to be and speak up before it's too late. Considering both seem like a totally plausible outcome, I'm gonna let you guys fill me in on what you're thinking. Do you think Kourtney Kardashian and Scott Disick are meant to be? What are some of your favorite couple moments from these two? Or do you think they're better off as co-parents and that Scott and Sofia should get married one day? Let it all out down below. For more celeb news, make sure to check out one of our other videos and our live morning show, The Morning Tea. We go live every day at 8:30 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. While you're at it, don't forget to shop the Hollyscoop store, and as always, click subscribe.